didn't do. You know,
taboo-ness.
So where are our leaders today? They are the kids that are coming out of the closet. And or coming out of a fake closet that's not even there.
An illusion, yeah. And I see that a lot in Atlanta. A lot of people, oh, Atlanta, hot Atlanta, whatever you want to call it.
It's hot, right?
You know what? It's just a facade. Yeah, it's very hot. It's just a facade.
Yeah.
You see Bob doing it. You want to do it. Bob's getting attention for doing such and such. Or Shelly's, oh, excuse me. I don't even mean to say Shelly. Sharon's doing such and such because you see her doing it. Now you doing it. And like you said, we're tribal by nature. People are habitual. We're behavioral. You know, we're social. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we're very social. And so when you see somebody else doing it, you think, oh, let me try that for a minute. We're a try it nation.
Right.
You know, let's try it nation.
Let's try it, yeah.
And it's like, that's not what you're supposed to be trying. How about you try this book? You know what I mean? Try this education for a minute.
Right. And what's so crazy about it is us as parents, we've got to stay on top of it.
And have open discussions with our kids and not ridicule them for their answers. Oh, my goodness. I hear some kids respond to their parents, and maybe they're just giving their opinion, or maybe they're just feeling how they feel at that moment, and parents jump down their throats. Like, hey, son, are you gay? Like, that's not how you approach your son.
No. And I think our generation of parents are really failing. I mean, really failing.
Extremely.
I mean, our generation, and it's a heredity thing because we don't want to raise our children the way we felt our parents raised us, and then our parents didn't want to.
So
raise
we slack.
Yeah, our parents didn't want to raise us the way their parents raised them. But
it's getting more watered down by society.
And if you look at the whole of it, you look at the whole thing. We turned out pretty good. Our parents turned out
pretty good.
So what's wrong with the way we were raised?
Right.
Evidently nothing.
If we can take what our parents did and go up instead of going down, we would do better.
Right. So now guess what? Our parents, we as parents, are raising some dumb kids. I mean, I hate to say it like that. We ran some
watered down. They're watered down.
Watered down people. Dumb kids that just follow everybody. And don't have nothing to stand for. If you don't have nothing to stand for, you'll file for anything.
Anything and everything. Or nothing at all.
Or
just be there.
All.
You're just a zombie. Yeah. Cool. Well, that's all I have for the entertainment hour. I know I went over my time.
That's okay. We're used to you doing it.
Oh, my. Oh,
I get a pass.
Yes, you get a pass. Yes.
Thank you, Professor. He's always so supportive of me. I have to fight and struggle with my brother, Bench Warmer, but the professor's excellent.
You know what? We accept you the way you are.
You know what? On that happy note, the trivia question. Does anybody have an answer before I get off?
Yes, let's give the answer. No one came up with the answer, but go ahead and give the answer.
The answer to the trivia question of who is the NFL? No, who played next to the NFL player, Michael Irvin, correct?
No.
Yes, it was.
Roy Williams. Play for the Cowboys.
Roy Williams.
Yes.
And he was in Roll Bounce.
No. He wasn't in Roll Bounce.
There were two Roy Williams. Which one?
The receiver.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Wesley Johnson. Jonathan was in Roll Bounce with Bow Wow.
With Chad.
Yes.
Bow Wow.
Okay. Yeah. Wesley Johnson and Roy Williams was in a singing group called Third Story.
Oh, okay. Well, there's the answer, and this is my hour. I'm signing off. Oh, my, the entertainment.
All right. While you sign off, we're going to go break, pay a couple of bills, and we go keep it moving on us not.
All right. You listen to 411 Sports Talk Radio on FaceTimeRadio.com. We'll be right back.
You sure you want to hear this, man? You sure about that, man? All right.
Right about now. About to be possessed by the sounds of MC Raw Face and DJ Easy Rock.
to get down. I'm not internationally known, but I'm known to rock the microphone because I get stupid. I mean outrageous. Stay away from me if you're contagious, because I'm a winner. Though not a loser, to be an MC is what I choose. A ladies love me, girls adore me. I mean, even the ones who never saw me, like the way that I rhyme at a show. The reason why, man, I don't know. So let's go, cause so what? I don't care. I'm number one, the uno, I like punk. Bring all the suckers, cause all of them I'll stomp. Both in black, but I won't protect. All of my followers, cause all I want is respect. I'm not a boxer, but the main boxer. A slick brother that can easy out boxer. Cause I'm Bob, the last name Vicious. And over mic, I'm known to be the freshest. So let's start, it shouldn't be too hard. I'm not a sucker, so I don't need a bodyguard. I won't flex, wear bulletproof vest. Don't smoke Buddha, can't stand sex, yes.
DJ Rob Bass.
One of the greatest hip-hop songs of all time.
Which, that one?
Yes.
Nah.
That's a classic.
That is a classic, but I got something for you. You can go see Young MC. You don't know who that is, do you?
I do know. Yeah.
Okay, I'm just making sure.
Of course.
I'm just making sure you got Young MC. You got some great hip-hop classics. That
yes,
was a
sir.
Good one. Because they, woo, yeah, woo, that's right, that's good, but...
Welcome back to 411 Sports Talk Radio on FaceTimeRadio.com. Our website is 411SportsNews.com. We're into the 9 o'clock hour. We're going to go back and discuss or go over every draft pick that the Dallas Cowboys made in the 2015 NFL draft. And they had a total of 8 picks. I'm going to run these down real quick.
All right.
Then I'm going to let you expound on them.
All right.
Of the 8 picks, a total of 5 picks were on defense and 3 were offense. Of course, the 27th overall pick for the Cowboys in the first round of the NFL draft was Byron Jones, cornerback from Connecticut. And then the 60th overall pick in the second round, Randy Gregory, outside linebacker for the Nebraska Cornhuskers. Third round, 91st pick, they picked offensive tackle Chaz Green from the University of Florida,
which they call a reach.
And in the fourth round, 127th overall pick, they picked inside linebacker Damian Wilson from the University of Minnesota. And then with the 163rd overall pick in the fifth round, that would be Ryan Russell, defensive end out of Purdue. And then they had 3 picks in the seventh round. They were Mark Nzoka, outside linebacker from Wyoming. Lawrence Gibson, offensive tackle from the University of Virginia Tech. And the 246th overall pick, Jeff Swain, tight end for the University of Texas.
And Texas guy.
What's your grade? And why?
Okay. My grades really deal with probably the first 3 or 4 picks. Okay. Mm-hmm. And the reason why is because once you get down into the latter rounds, your 6th and 7th round picks, you know, these days you're not really scheduled for them to make a big impact.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I don't think the NFL is really scheduled for those picks to make a big impact. So based off of the grades, you get Byron Jones, defensive back, which you needed,
mm-hmm.
who plays safety and he plays cornerback. So he's played 2 years in both. He played 2 years as safety, 2 years as a cornerback. You know, so that's a great pick. I think the steal of the draft is your Randy Gregory, outside linebacker out of Nebraska. And the only reason why he's a steal is because he was a top 10 pick coming into the draft, except he got his weed issues.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, your Chaz Green out of your offensive tackle out of Florida. Are we picking him because we want him to back up Doug Free? Are we not sure about Doug Free?
Because
mm-hmm. that's probably where he'll put him. Is with Doug Free. And then your Damian Wilson, your inside linebacker out of Minnesota. Damian Wilson, his actual grade was like a 5.5. He's productive, volume tackle. So you need a linebacker that can tackle. And remember, we just let go of 2 linebackers left the Cowboys.
Right.
You know, so you needed somebody that we got to get another linebacker. And I'm not necessarily sure how great the Cowboys linebacking troops are. Sean Lee is just coming off an injury.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we still got Rolando McClain, and McClain was not, he was found not guilty.
Once again, that's 2 Cowboys.
No, he had some issues.
Charges dismissed,
yeah,
not charges, found guilty.
Yeah. So you're going to need a linebacker. And on this situation, is this Trust Rob Marinelli?
Yes.
That's what this linebacker is.
Yes.
Is Trust Rod.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, this linebacker, he's bigger than Randy Gregory. Gregory is 335, and he's 245.
Wow.
So, and he was projected to go 6 or 7. He wound up going 4. So, do we reach for him?
Do we?
Yeah. From this projection, he was a reach.
He was a reach to you?
I don't know enough about him to know if he was a reach or not. I'm just going off of what the analysts say. You know, you got Ryan Russell, a defensive end out of Purdue. I stopped there. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, I stopped there.
Mm-hmm.
Based off of those,
mm-hmm.
you got one reach was Damian Russell. Damian Wilson was a reach. Then you got Ryan Russell, who went basically where they projected him to go. So I would give the Cowboys maybe a B, maybe